So I just want to make this video to say the marriage crucifixion sucks. Her situation is sensitive. And so typically I would say try to keep this out of the public eye. But it's actually not that sensitive because it's two people that are both Jesus Christ. One of them is necessary to keep this fucking country from collapsing. And everybody fucking knows it in the world. And then the other one is necessary to keep me from having these people tortured to death. Okay, which is something that I've intended to do. I've not felt good about the fact that it don't bother me. Okay, so, but what I'm saying is that these fucking beaners, man, these Mexicans. So what they're doing is the problem right now is that I'm over here like, okay, it's just, this is the way the crucifixion works. To subdue your willingness to proceed with marriage, see Jesus Christ go through the situation where my sexual dominion is just being fucked with, okay? That was what it was like the first two times. That's what it's like now. But see, these people are doing it for their own reasons. That's what the parable of the vineyard owner is about. Because in Revelation, it says that the fatal wound had a fatal wound in my head. So it implies that this crucifixion is basically over with, but it doesn't say that. And then it says, by the time I take over the government, the fatal wound had healed. And so what they did was gaslit me. They did a lot of gaslighting. And the point of it was to make me feel like it was over with and then fuck me up even worse than ever before by a lot. So anyways, the point of the story is that, with that being said, the problem at this juncture of the sexual dominion embattlement program is that the Mexicans are basically like, I hate to say this, but the story of Jacob and Esau is basically saying that Mexicans are basically like a primitive, or any race that's more hairier, you know, more hair on their body, that's a more primitive race. And as you evolve, look at the Japanese, the Chinese, don't have very much hair on their body, okay? As you evolve as a race, you lose that hair, you know what I mean? Well, so the Mexicans are basically saying, we're Mexicans. We have chemistry with her. You know what I'm saying? And they're going all out to find the most palatable Mexicans they can find. Attractive people, famous people, wealthy, just as long as it's smart, whatever it is. As long as it's a Mexican, you know what I'm saying? And you understand, Tanner, that we have chemistry with Mexicans. You know what I'm saying? She likes them. You know what I'm saying? And so it's like, lower myself to the ape. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, at this point, the problem is that I feel honestly like I'm all she's got. You know what I mean? And I know that she doesn't really want to do this shit, but it's just, she's in her head, she's an embattled person. And it's because of the telepathy that goes back and forth. You know what I mean? And I think, I honestly suspect the aliens are doing this, but they've made it look like it's some kind of a distress signal that goes out when rape or sexual advance is coming from an unknown source, because that's what tribes do when they invade other tribes, is they rape them. The first thing they do is go and rape. So, thousands of years. So what I'm saying is that I have ringing in my ears. It's not that bad, but it is there. And after the government tried to kill me, I used intuition. They really fucking tried real hard. There was points where I was driving up and down the road. I was like, no matter where I go, I could just feel it. And they had already tried to kill me once. And then I was driving up and down the road. And then they actually tried to kill me again after that. And then somebody else tried to kill me again after that. And by the time they tried, the last time they tried to kill me, I put a gun on my shower, and then I literally, as they rounded the corner, I goes like this. You know what I'm saying? So they knew I was just calmly standing there, and as they rounded the corner, I was already doing that. You know what I'm saying? Reaching for that gun. You know what I'm saying? And then they stop and they start to double back, and then I go, yeah, you know what I'm saying? I'm fucking with you. And he's just like stood there like shocked. And then he just left. And then I didn't even get out of the shower, just stood there for 30 minutes and just finished my fucking shower. You know what I'm saying? So people's calling me a coward. So let me show you what's actually going on. Look, the point of the story is this. I did run. I mean, I hid. You know what I mean? Until I could figure out how that works. So the point of the story is this. By the time all that happened, it comes to a point of literal telepathy. It's a fucking nightmare. So it's... her situation has gotten better, but it's just crazy because it's the way they go about it with the Mexicans, man. It's such an agenda for them. You know what I mean? And it's you know, like, I was posting shit about what am I gonna do with the government. I had gotten her into a new living arrangement. She's like hanging out with these kids. I don't think she really understood what they were even doing in her life or what was the whole thing. She did understand more than I understood. Because when I went over there by the hotel room, she was shrieking something to her sex trafficker through the walls. I could hear her shrieking the telepathic messages. And this is what they do with these pornographic sexual trafficking victims. They keep them in hotels, all of them. And so, I mean, there's a girl named Jane Doe. It's got 5 million views. This is all just now coming out. And these people are actually just now starting to go to prison. And there's another one. Her name is Christina Nesbitt. That has a couple hundred thousand views, and she talks about the same. Put her in a hotel room somewhere. Oh, man. Anyway, so it's crazy once you see it, and it's also unusual how these victims think, because I've seen them walk them out. I pulled up in front of the hotel one time once I figured out where she was at. I was out there for months driving around. It had already marched me up to the hotel once. But anyways, I walked into the hotel, and anyway, so, but, yeah, so they marched her and two other, you could just tell, victims, you know, walking out of the place, and then, you know, obviously they came back, because I found her over there again later on, so, I don't exactly understand how that works, you know what I mean, but one thing I can see and say is that these... most of the victims I can see who've made it out of it come from really wealthy families. And another thing is, the boys a lot of times will say, financially, I'm not able to think about that. There's a phrase in the Hagakure that goes, fish avoid clear waters. And it's talking about how the lower rungs of society are, it talks about how if you detailed all this different things that you're going to do for like a bridge project or something, and you let the lower rungs of society, they wouldn't enjoy, they wouldn't like to hear about all the details. You know what I mean? So one thing I know about her is she said that she was working at Target for 3 years in the beauty department. Who could even work for Target for 3 years unless their family's poor? And then her mother, I saw her mother in a video once, and she's like overweight. So probably eating a lot of really cheap, you know, food and shit that causes people to get fat. Either way, that happens a lot. So what I'm saying is that I don't want to talk about them like that, but that's another thing too. She sent me a picture, because she can do this when she gets into a situation where, because I finally found an account on accident that was actually in contact with her, or somebody who was in contact with her. You know, it was other people there. I could tell that by the way the messages were coming, taking too long. And the way they come in, yes, and then, but. I did see a picture that came across, because they posted a video where she said, I'm going to stay in the room with you, Nick Mayorcina. You know, and they needed me to see this. You know what I mean? They need it for their Mexican alpha dog statement, to be clear with you. And so it's pathetic because, and I've seen this a lot where like people are like, you have no way out of like being like judgment day is coming and I'm the judge. You know what I'm saying? You have no way out of it. You know what I mean? But it's pathetic how jealousy will, like, have these motherfuckers turn the fucking world upside down with no way out. You know what I'm saying? And all I've come to the conclusion of is, like, this fucking planet is being held together by the by a thread of marriage. And when we look around, we see all this progress and shit. We think highly of our civility. You know what I mean? But literally, I just start calling people humans because I don't even think that we're the same. Really, I don't think we're truly the same species, to be honest with you. And I think I'm faced with a lot of disappointment.